Her Majesty Queen Sarlote Tupou III, Tonga's original Queen of Hearts.
At Papakura military camp, Queen Sarlote speaks of the link between Tonga and New Zealand in defence.
The Tongan monarch captured British hearts at the coronation of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II in London 1953, when she honoured the British monarch by riding in an open carriage through the pouring rain.
One of Queen Sarlote's words of wisdom in Tonga: if my people are la aina, why am I in the house? If my people are soaking wet in the rain, why am I warm in a carriage?
Born on the 13th of March 1900 at the Royal Palace in Nuku'alofa, she was the only daughter of King Taufa'ahau Tupou II and Queen Lavinia. The young Princess Sarlote Mafileo Pilolevu married her consort Tungi Mailefihi in 1917 when she was just 17 years old. She ascended to the throne the following year and became the ruler of the Friendly Islands.
I had a most wonderful trip to England to attend the coronation of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth.
Queen Sarlote reigned for almost 48 years. She united the Pacific Kingdom at a time when there were growing fears of foreign powers taking over. And while some local chiefs resisted central government, she worked hard to introduce modern education, health and agriculture. However, away from the public, the Queen had her own personal challenges. She lost two half-sisters to illness and had several miscarriages. Then her son William Tuku'aho died aged 15 before her husband Tungi Mailefihi died 5 years later.
All these things, very painful, to go through one after the other. And now Tungi was there for her when she governs the country. Now he passed away. What do I do? All these adds to why she was very, very special in her composition.
A gifted poet, she turned to songwriting as an outlet to express her feelings. She wrote more than 100 compositions, including songs, lullabies, recitals, laments, and drama.
So she composed the song, and then it gets given to the punakes, and they go out and find the tune, and they put the tune into it. And then they come back, and they sing it to her at the palace. So she listened, and then she will say, no, that doesn't fit there. The way you pronounce the word doesn't fit. So, and then they worked on it into perfection.
She composed from the heart, and the language was deep. Her music broke down barriers in Tonga's hierarchical system.
To her, if I have to leave a legacy, I will have to leave it in some form of way. And she did this marvelous thing about putting her words of wisdom in her composition. So every composition, it has a message. And that is why it's so deep. And she's very, very good at using the heliaki, the metaphors, to tell things and give people wisdoms.
I feel that I have come as a friend and for such a good welcome that you've given me. I'm sure I'm going to enjoy my stay in Sydney.
Queen Sarlote's music is still performed around the world, and for many Tongans who live overseas, it's their link back home.
When you have to go to your roots, go to Queen Sarlote's music, and in there you will find your root. Because to me, that was one of her biggest legacy, bringing everything into music and passing it on.
In 1965, Her Majesty passed away in Auckland and was laid to rest in Malaikula, Nuku'alofa. She may be gone, but her legacy lives on.